6:45 in the morning, and I thought we'd come back to Grantham to do that public footpath that we saw back on the last video. It's very early, it's a little bit dark still, even though it's sunny, so I hope you enjoy the one. Well, this isn't the public footpath I had in mind. I can't find the one that I found last time, so we're going to have to make do with this one. Still makes a nice walk. No one's about. Only the birds. No cockerel calling. Cool to wake up in the morning in a place like this, looking out onto this. Incredible. Oh, that looks like our next style to cross. But I think we'll have a wander up here first. Look at these old trees, dead. Another old dead tree. Birds are certainly happy. Here we are. little drainage ditch. Wow, look at that hot air balloon. Someone's out early. It's in the shape of, oh, it's a couple of hot air balloons. Looks like they're taking off. Hey, that's pretty good, isn't it? That's really cool, that is. I've never been that close to a takeoff site. Grepham's UFOs. Now that is quite something. Good morning.
Hello.
How are you doing?
All right, I think.
Jolly good.
It's early good time.
Yeah. Do these balloons often take off from here?
First time I've seen them launch from this farm in quite a while. Normally they're launched from North Chapel.
All right.
One of the operators is based up there. The other one's near Whisperer Green.
Okay.
I think the Whisperer Green one's called Virgin Balloons.
Crikey.
But these might be a couple of independents. I'm
not sure. I came out to film this, you know, early morning in this is Grepham, isn't it?
Yeah,
Grepham. I certainly didn't expect this.
Oh, it's a
this is a bonus. This is a bonus for me, yeah. All right. That's incredible.
Oh, they've got a super morning for it.
Yeah. Absolutely. Fantastic. I bet that's peaceful up there.
Yeah, it's just the sound of the burner and...
Yeah.
Later in the day, when it gets a bit more firmly, you often get gliders ridge soaring.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, from Parham, over near Storrington.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I've heard about the ones at Storrington. Yeah.
Several years ago, one of those ran out of lift and put down in a field in the next farm.
Right.
And
what, purposefully, you mean?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Waited for his pickup and was taking the wings off for it to go into the trailer.
Yeah, absolutely. It's true. And you live in Grepham, I take it?
Yes, I'm in the village.
Right, okay. Lovely place to live, isn't it?
It's great in terms of the countryside and the walking, yeah.
Yeah.
So
peaceful.
It is. It gets busy in the mornings with the school run.
Oh, right.
There's a primary school at the top of the hill, and then Of course we've got Seaford College, the big public school.
Oh, yes, that's right, on the corner.
That's it.
Yeah, I know.
And
still, what you call busy and what I call busy are probably rush hour for you is probably a couple of horses coming up the road or something.
Yeah, a lot of horses.
Yeah,
it's good horse country. Yes, a lot of riding to be had.
Superb. Okay,
yeah.
Thanks a lot for chatting. Thank you.
Bye
bye. Well, I didn't expect to be chatting to anyone at, where are we, 7:05 in the morning in the middle of a country field. It's surprising what you come up against on these walks. Those balloons, they were great. We're all kids at heart, I suppose. Wish I was there when they were preparing and climbing into the basket and everything. That would have really made a good video. Anyway, onwards and upwards. Well, here's the end of the public footpath. What happens from here on? No one knows. So I don't know where this leads to. Little house through there. We are now in early June, so summer's still not upon us yet. I left Tati asleep in bed this morning. It was 5 to 6 when I left home. Well, Lovely little farmhouse tucked away. Looks like silage bales or something. This is, by the way, someone's farm I'm walking through, but as you can see, there's a public footpath, public right of way.